Welcome to Maths class. My name is Olujimi Gabriel. Last time we started from area, and we defined area as the measure of the surface of any shape. And we look into some basic shape like triangle, square, parallelogram. Now we'll be looking at the area of rectangles. Area of rectangles. How do we get rectangles? When we divide the area, a rectangle diagonally, we have rectangle, triangle. 1, 2. That is, this diagonal has divided this rectangle into two equal right angle triangles. We can also get it from parallelogram. This line is called diagonal, and it divide the parallelogram into two triangles, equal triangles. When you divide a rectangle, you have two equal right angles, but for parallelogram, it is not. Now, any diagonal of a parallelogram divided it into two equal triangles. Now, let's use rectangle as an example here. Now this is the base, this is the height, this is the base, this is the height. We know this side of a rectangle is called the width or the breadth, and this side is called length. By the time you divide it into two, we have two equal right angles triangles. Now the area of this rectangle is length times b. Now we've divided it into two equal halves. That means the area of one triangle is half of the area of a rectangle. The same thing applies here. Now, here is our formula to calculate for the area of triangle. Area of parallelogram equals to base times height, just like we have in the case of rectangle. Since the diagonal divides the parallelogram into two equal triangles, the area of one triangle is given by 1 over 2 times base times height. That is, you divide the area of parallelogram by 2 to give you the area of one triangle. Now, look at this example. I believe we now know the formula to calculate for area of triangle. Now, this side is the height, while this side is the base. From our formula, we said A equals to 1 all over 2 times base times height. Now, from this diagram, our base is what? 9, while our height is 12. This side is always the height, while this side is the what? Base. This is angle 90. Now, 2 year 1, 2 year 6. By the time you do that, you have 54 centimeters squared. Now, look at it here. 1 over 2 times base times height. Now, when you put everything, that is what you have, your answer is 54 centimeter square, just like I've explained before. Example 2. Calculate the area of the triangle. Now, this side is the base, while this middle is the height. This 7 is just for decoration, because we will not be needing it now. We only need the base and the what? Height. Now, what is our height? Our height is 5 centimeters, and the base B equals to 8 centimeters. Now, here is our formula. By the time you slot in everything, that is, this is the base and this is the height. 2 year 1, 2 year 4. 4 times 5 will be 20 centimeter square. That is that. Here is another example. In this diagram, we have two triangles. One is like this, and one is like this. Here is A, C, D, and this one is A, B, C. For this first triangle, the base is 15 centimeter and the height is 20 centimeter. For this second triangle, we have 7 centimeter, and for the height of this place, we have 24 centimeter. When you check this diagram very well, we have triangle ABC. This sign means triangle. Triangle ABC. This is the, we used our formula to calculate for the area, that is 1 over 2 times 20 times 15. Our height is 20, while our base is 15. Now, for the second triangle, we have 1 over 2 times 24 times 7. Now, by the time you find the area of this, the first one is 154, the second one is 84, which is equals to 234 centimeter square. That is, you add the area of this and this to give you the total area of the shape. That is that. Now, another shape we'll be looking at is the trapezium. A trapezium has two parallel sides, then the distance between them, the top and the bottom, we call it height. Now, we have different shape of trapezium, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. It could be this, 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 or this, depending on which one you are giving is trapezium. Now, how do we get the formula to calculate the area of trapezium? Now, draw a line from C to join B. Now, you can see that we now have two triangles. This is the first triangle, and this is another triangle. One, two. One is triangle ABC, while the other is triangle BCD. Now, look at. To find the total area of this shape, which is trapezium, we find the area of triangle ABC, which is ABC plus triangle BDC. And we know the area to be followed to calculate for the area of triangle. Now, look at 1 over 2 times AB. AB is the base of this first triangle, and the height is H. Then in triangle BDC, BDC is the base of this triangle. Now, the height is also H. That's why we have it here. Now, look at. That is AB times H plus 1 over 2 DC times H. That is AB. That is the base of the first triangle. This is the first triangle, the second triangle. The area of the first triangle, the area of the second triangle. Now, bring what is common out from both. We have 1 over 2 bracket, open bracket, AB plus DC times H. Now, what do we have on AB? A. Look at it here. Now, what do we have on base? That is CD. That is the base. That is B. That is the formula to calculate for area of trapezium. To calculate the area of trapezium, that is 1 over 2 open bracket A plus B close bracket times the height. Now, look at this example very well. Now, we have to calculate the area of this trapezium. This is the top and this is the base. This is the height. You can see this, if this base is 5, this is also 5. Now, this is the formula to calculate for the area of trapezium. You know your A, you know what your B stands for, and what H represents. Now, our A is 6, that is the top. The base is what? 16. And the height is 5. Now, 6 plus 16 will give me 22 times 5. By the time you use these two to divide 22, it will be 11. Now, look at 11 times 5 is what? 55, correct. Our answer is 55 centimeters square. That is that. Another example is this. Look at this, another type of trapezium. Of course, still have two parallel sides. This is the top and this is the base. Now, look at this is the formula. What is your A? A is 20 and B is what? 25. And H is 6. You can see 13 is not useful here. So 20 plus 25, that is 45 times 6. That will be 1 over 2 times 45 times 6. Look at. Now, when you divide 45 by 2, it will be 22.5. When you multiply 22.5 times 6, your answer will be 4135 centimeters square. You can see it's very simple if only you know how to apply the formula correctly. Know which letter stands for which number, then you are good to go. Now, look at this example again. We have a trapezium. We actually use the area of triangle to solve this. Now, look at. This is A, B, C, D. This is the height. The height is 8, Y base is 13, and the top is 16. Draw a line. You can see it forms through triangle. One, this is the first triangle, and this. Never mind my drawing, it's not up, it's not to scale. Now, this is the first triangle, this is the second triangle. Now, using your formula to calculate for the area of the first triangle will be 1 over 2. What is the base? 6. What is the height? 8. Equals to 52 centimeters square. Area of the second triangle, 1 over 2 times, what is the base? 13. Times 8 equals to 52. Why this is 6, 24 centimeters square. Sorry. Now that is what they did here. Now, by the time you now add the two area together, you have 76 centimeters square. That is that. If you don't want to use the area, 1 over 2 brackets A plus B times height, you can also use this method, but always use the one that you feel comfortable with. Now, we move to area of circle. Recall we said the diameter is equal to 2 times the radius. Now, R is equal to diameter all over 2. Now, where R is the radius and the pi is always 3.14 or 22 all over 7. This is the symbol for pi. That is 22 all over 7 or 3.14. And this is the formula to calculate the area of a circle by r squared. Now, look at, we also have semicircle. It's just like when you have a full circle and you divide it into two equal parts, equal halves. This is one, this is two. One is called semicircle. Now, to find the area of a semicircle, you find the area of the full circle, then divide by two, like what we have here. Anytime you are asked to calculate the area of a semicircle, find the area for the full circle, then divide your value by two. It will give you the value of semicircle. Now look at this example. This is the formula to calculate for the area of a circle. Your r equals to 6. We have been given the radius to be what? 6, because we know from this middle point to the circumference is the radius. Now, we know our pi to be 22 all over 7. Now, 6, you know r is raised to the power 2. That means 6 raised to the power 2. Whatever the value of r is, it will be raised to the power 2. Now, which means 6 times 6. When you have 6 squared, it means 6 times 6. Now, when you divide 22 divided by 7, you have 3.14 times 36. That is what you should have next. By the time you divide this, you have this. Now, when you multiply 3.14 and 36, you have 103.04 centimeter squared. Another example, you can see from here, we are given the diameter and not radius. Before you can use this formula, you have to get your radius first so that it won't be too large for you to undo. And we know that r equals to d all over 2. Now, look at it here. This is the formula. You can see we have r here and not diameter. Now, to make it more simpler, you have to find your r from diameter, which is d all over 2. And our d is 23. Divided by 2, you have 11.5 centimeter. Now, bring it into this formula, which is 3.14. No, our pi is 3.14 or 22 over 7. Now, 11.5. This is the implication of it. 3.14 times 11.5 times 11.5. Now, our total answer is 415.265 centimeter square. Now, compound shape. You can see this shape. This shape comprises of two basic shapes. One is a semicircle and the other is rectangle. Now, here is 20 feet. Here is 32 feet. Now, if this place is 20, that means this side of this rectangle is also 20. Now, look at. The first thing to find is, you find the area of the semicircle. And this is the formula to calculate for the area of semicircle. And we have our pi to be 3.14. And look at, I have 10 here. Who can guess where this 10 comes from? Let me explain to you. Our diameter for the semicircle is 20. Now, from there, our r equals to diameter over 2, which is 20 divided by 2 equals to 10. That was how we got 10. Now, by the time you square the 10, it will be 100. That is 100 times 100. That is I mean, 10 times 10 will be equals to 100. When you use 2 to divide 100, you have 50. Now, the answer is 157 feet square. Now, the second part is to calculate for the area of the rectangle, which is here. Now, recall, we know that area of rectangle equals to length times breadth. And what is the length? The length is 32 and the breadth is 20. Don't forget, this 20 is for both the semicircle and the rectangle. This side form the width for the diameter of the semicircle and also form the width of the rectangle. Now, this is the value you get when you multiply 32 and 20. Now, the total area of the shape, that is everything, you now add area of semicircle and area of rectangle, you have 797 square feet. That is how to calculate for the area of compound shapes. Now, assignment. Look at what you have here. You have a square. Inside it, you have a circle. You are to calculate the area of this part. Calculate the area of this green part. How do you do that? You find the area of the bigger shape, then find the area of the circle, then you subtract. Whatever your answer is the area of this green part. That is that. This also is the same thing as the previous one. You find the area of the bigger circle. You have been given two diameters. One is 14 and one is 7. You find the area of the bigger circle. Then find the area of the smaller circle. Don't forget, you have to find radius. Find radius from here also. Then, when you find the area, then you subtract. Whatever your answer is the area of this part that is remaining. The same thing applies here. I want you to apply the last example we did on compound shape to calculate for the area of this shape. Now, in summary, the area of a shape is a measure of its surface. Area is measured in units such as centimeter square or meter square. The area of common shapes are as follows. This is for rectangle, square is L square, parallelogram is base times height, while triangle is when you divide the area of parallelogram by 2, that will give you area of triangle, which is half base times height. Now, area of trapezium is 1 over 2 open bracket A plus B times I, and the area of circle is pi R square. Now, for further reading, get hold of your new general mathematics on page 11 for your further reading and other exercise. Till I come your way next time, have a great day.